So good morning students, today I will explain you about the number system. Okay, we'll discuss the number system. If you have any doubts, you can ask me. Okay, so see here, number system and their conversion. Number system and conversion. Okay, so we have a total five number systems are there. Okay, so the first number system is a decimal, so that means basically we are concentrating on the conversion only, number system conversion. Okay, so number system conversion. So so here if you see, first is decimal to any other two decimal. Okay, first any, one second. Okay, so first of all we'll see the number system. Okay, after that we'll see the conversion. Okay, types of numbers. Okay, so how many types of numbers are there? We'll see types of numbers. So first is a binary number system. Okay, and second one is octal, and third one is decimal, and fourth one is hexadecimal. Okay, so here so mainly this binary is there. Binary is mainly used in the data communication. Okay, the data communication we are using this binary representation. And so here this decimal means manually, so manually this decimal number system we are using. Suppose like if you want to book any bus ticket, so the bus ticket price is 100, you will enter. So if you are applying online, you will enter the price as 100. Okay, so the manually, whatever the manual numbers you are using, that those are nothing but decimal number system. And next you have the radix of the number system. So that means for the binary number system, the radix is 2. Okay, so the radix is 2 means so that means the number of digits. So you need to remember the number of digits for any number system. Okay, for any number system is suppose consider R is radix. So from 0 to R minus 1. So from 0 to R minus 1. So that means for the binary, so what is the range? So from 0 to R minus 1 is how much? 0 to 1. Okay, 0 to 1 is nothing but this is the range of the number. Okay, so 0 to 1, that means whatever the binary numbers are there, that those are represented in 0 to 1. Okay, and next and in this octal, so number of digits used is from 0 to 8 minus 1. Okay, so here the radix is how much? Radix equal to 8 minus 1. So the numbers, number of digits used are 0 to 7 for octal number system. Okay, and for decimal number system, the radix is 10 and the number of digits used are from 0 to 10 minus 1. So that means the numbers are 0 to 9. Okay, so 0 to 9. So that means whatever the numbers present in the decimal are between the 0 to 9 only. Okay, suppose 10 is there. 10 means again this one is between the 0 to 9, and 0 is between the 0 to 9 only. Okay, so the numbers are between 0 to 9. And if it is a hexadecimal representation, the radix is 16 and the numbers are from 0 to 16 minus 1. So that means the numbers are 0 to 15. The numbers are 0 to 15. Okay, so here you need to remember that base or radix. Okay, for any for any number, you have base or radix. Okay, so base or radix, so that is the range from 0 to R minus 1. So this is a base or radix. So this is the formula for maximum number. To in order to find out the maximum number, so this is the formula 2 r minus 1. Okay. Here, suppose if it is a hexadecimal representation. So for hexadecimal representation, so 10 is nothing but A, and 11 is B, 12 is C, 13 is D, 14 is E, okay, 14 is E, and 15 is F, 15 is F, okay, 15 is F, okay. So that means you can ask why this this conversion means 10 is A in hexadecimal and 15 is F. So in order to remove the confusion, so that means suppose 215 is there, okay. So 215 means this number, it is represented in decimal or hexadecimal, okay. Suppose if it is a represented in decimal, so this is nothing but 215, okay. So but if you represent this number in hexadecimal, so this is nothing but 2F. So 15 is what? F, okay. So if it is 2F, this is, you can understand that this is in hexadecimal. So if it is 215, you can understand that this is in decimal, okay. So without suffix, suppose any number indicating without a suffix, so 125 is there, without suffix, by default this is a decimal number, okay. So you need to indicate suffix. Suppose 16 is there, this is what hexadecimal, okay. Suppose 238 is there, so this is a suffix. 8 is nothing but octal, okay. Suppose 1011 is there, so to the base 2 means what is this for? Binary, okay. And decimal also you can represent 232 to the base 10, so this is nothing but decimal. So to the base 10, that is nothing but decimal. So you need, so whatever the number is there, you need to represent with the suffix, okay. So the suffix gives that the given number is there in the particular number system, okay. Now determine the possible unknown base of a relation, okay. So how to determine? So determine the possible unknown base of a relation, okay. Suppose if you take example, root 22 equal to 6 is there. So what is the maximum value of digit? So maximum value of digit equal to what? 6. Okay. So maximum value of digit equal to 6. So that means if you want to find out the base should be greater than or equal to 7. Okay. So that means here, so if radix is R, okay, what is the maximum value is nothing but r minus 1, okay. So but here if it is a maximum value 6, okay, if it is maximum value 6, so what is the base value radix? You can take that base as plus 1, no? So that is maximum value plus 1. So that means maximum value should be greater than or equal to 7, okay. Now so he given that root 22 equal to 6, no? Suppose let us take if you want to represent this one in terms of number, so you have to represent like this: summation of digit into b power place value. Here pv is nothing but place value, okay. So here if you see, so that means here if you want to represent, it's here b. So here the place value is 0 and the place value is 1, okay. That means units place and tens place. And here B, if you see, so the place value is 0, okay. So if you want to represent this one, so I'm finding out the base of this one, okay. So B value, base of this one. So here square root of, how you can find out, 2 into B power 1, okay. And 2 into B power 0 equal to 6 into B power 0, okay. So that means what you are getting, this is nothing but 2b plus 2 equal to 6b, 2b plus 2 equal to 6b. So 6. So b power 0 is how much? 1. So b power 0 is what? 1. Okay. So squaring on both sides, what you are getting? So 2b, 2b plus 2 equal to 36. 2b equal to 36 minus 2. Equal to what? 70. So here you got base equal to what? 70. So here base should be greater than or equal to 7. No? So I indicated that base is equal to greater than or equal to 7. So I got the base as 70. Okay. So like this, if he given some relation and he's asking to find out possible base of any number, you can find like this. Okay. So like this, you will get the base. Okay. And so next number system conversion. From where? From starting onwards.
From example,
this root 22 you are asking?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, here place value, how you keep in 0 and 1, please?
0 and 1, that means suppose if you take one example, let us take the decimal value 2, 4, 5, 6 is there. Okay. So here, what is the place value? Units place and tens place. Okay. And hundreds place. And this is thousandth place. Okay. So what is the place value? Suppose if you want to represent this one, and this is 1, 2, 3, 4. So that means what is the radix? 10, no? So how you can represent? This is 6 into 10 power 1 plus this is nothing but weight. 10 is nothing but weight. So 5 into 10 square plus 4 into 10 cube plus 2 into 10 power 4. Okay. So like this you can represent, no? For any number you can represent like this, no? So that means here place value is represented like this. So that means a 0th place, 1's place. So that means this is a units place and this is a tens place. So that means so here you don't know the weight. Okay. Either the base of the number means base means radix. Base is nothing but the radix. Okay. So in which number system it is there, not given. You need to find out. Okay. So for that, you have to write in terms of this one. So that means any number is represented like this. Okay. The number is represented as summation of digit into b power place value. So whatever the digit, here digit is there. So 2 is the digit into b power place value. Is it okay? Any doubt in this?
Oh, okay, sir. Okay.
Shall I scroll down?
Okay, sir.
Okay. So next number system. So here there are five types are there. One is decimal. To any other. First decimal to any other. And next any other. To decimal. Any other to decimal. And octal. To binary. Or binary to octal, that means vice versa. Okay, so vice versa. And next hexadecimal to binary, hexadecimal to binary, or binary to decimal, that is vice versa. Okay, binary to hexadecimal. And next so fifth conversion, octal to hexa decimal, octal to hexadecimal, or hexadecimal to octal. Okay, that is vice versa. Okay, so that means So you have so decimal number system. So that means for the decimal number system, you have the radix 10. Okay, base is 10, and you can convert decimal to any other. Any other means what? You can convert decimal to binary. Okay, so that means two numbers will be there. Decimal to octal. Okay, 8 numbers. And decimal to hexadecimal, okay, hexadecimal, 16 numbers. Or in general, you can convert decimal to n, means the number which is having the radix n minus 1, okay, so that means n number in general, okay. So this is how we can convert from decimal to any other, okay. Any other to decimal means what? You can convert binary to. So this is binary, and this is octal, and this is hexadecimal, okay, and this is decimal. So you can convert any other to decimal means what? You can convert binary to decimal, and octal to decimal, hexadecimal to decimal. So like this you can convert, okay. So that means you can convert decimal to any other or any other to decimal. Okay, and you have this octal to binary, binary to octal, and hexadecimal to binary, binary to hexadecimal, and by octal to hexadecimal, hexadecimal to octal, directly you can't find out. You have to use an intermediate conversion. That means suppose if you are converting octal to hexadecimal, first whatever the octal value is there, you need to convert into binary. After that you can convert into hexadecimal, okay. So this is how you can do. So we'll see one problem. Let us take 24 to the base 10 is there. 24 to the base 10 is there. So this you need to convert into binary. Okay. So binary 24 to the base 10, you need to convert it to binary. So for doing this decimal to any other, you need to do successive division. Okay. So you need to do which one? Successive division. Successive division with respect to number, with respect to number. So when you are doing the successive division, so you are getting the remainder, okay. So when you are getting the remainder, you have to take, after getting all the remainders, you need to take top, bottom to top. So here if you see, so this example 24 is there, so that means 2 times, if I am doing 12, 2 12s, so what is the remainder? 0. And 2 6 sir, and what is the remainder? 0. And 2 3 sir, what is the remainder? 0. And 2 1 sir, and what is the remainder? 1. So you have to take from bottom to top. You have to take from bottom to top. So that means 24 in decimal, that is equal to what? 1 1 0 0 0 in binary. Okay, 1 1 0 0 in binary. Similarly, suppose the decimal to if I want to find out octal, so 24 same number, if I want to find out the octal representation, okay, what, how you can do, how you can do, so this is 24 is there, so you need to do successive division. So 8, how many times? 8 3 sir, the remainder is 0. You have to take bottom to top, so that means 24 to the base 10 equal to what? In decimal equal to 308, okay, 308 in octal. So 30 in octal, 30 in octal, okay. Similarly, suppose 24 decimal I want to convert into hexadecimal, okay. So so that means to the base 16, okay. So 24, you need to do successive division, that is 16. 16 how many times? One time. So 24 minus 16 is how much? Remainder is 8. So that means you should take bottom to top. So 24 to the base 10 equal to what? 18 to the base 16. 18 to the base 16. Okay. So like this, you need to convert whatever the decimal number is there into any other, means you can convert decimal to binary, decimal to octal, decimal to hexadecimal, okay. Did you note it down? Did you note it? Shall I scroll up? Shall I scroll down?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let us take the number with a decimal point. Okay. So like 24.25 is there. 24.25. You need to convert into binary. Okay. 24.25 need to convert into binary. So anyway, 24 you got in the previous problem. So that means 24 to the base 10 equal to what? 110 110 00 00. Okay. And this decimal, what you need to do, multiplication. Okay. Decimal to any other number. If you multiply, what you are getting? So you need to multiply with the radix, whatever the radix is there, you need to multiply. So 0.25 into 2 is nothing but 0.5. So you need to bring this zero here, and again you take 0.5 into 2. So here you are getting 1.0. So 1 you to take here, again 0.0 into 2 equal to what? You are getting 0.0 only. Okay. So that means here you are getting 0 only. Okay. So here this is 1. This is 1. Okay. So this is 1. Okay. After doing this, what you need to do? You need to take from top to bottom. Okay. So 24.25 to the base 10 equal into 110 00.010. Okay. So that means till how much time you need to do, means you can truncate to like 2, 3 or 4 values. You can truncate to 3 or 4 values. So after that, no need to do. So 3 or 4 values you can do, and you can write in the decimal, this binary decimal representation. Okay. So here, this is the binary representation for 24.25. Okay. So like this you need to do. Okay. Next, if you see, find the binary equivalent of decimal representation 23.9 to the base 10. You need to convert into binary. Okay. So first, what you need to do? So whatever the decimal is there, you need to do successive division. Okay. So that means you can remember like this: decimal to other number system. So this decimal to other numbers. This is nothing but decimal. Decimal to other number system. Okay. So DOA. So this is nothing but we are doing successive division. You need to do. So D is nothing but you need to do successive division. Okay. You can remember like this. Okay. So 23 is there, you are doing successive division. So to how many times? To 11 times, remainder is 1. To 5 times, the remainder is 1. And to 2 times, remainder is 1. And to 1 times, remainder is 0. Okay. So you should take from bottom to top. Again, so what you are getting over here, this is 10 10 111 you are getting, 10 111 to the base 2 you are getting. Okay. And next to the base is there, 0.9 is there. What you need to do, you need to multiply. So 0.9 into 2 is how much? 1.8. so you need to take out this one. Okay. If I have to write here, and 0.8 into 2, so what you are getting? 1.6 you are getting. So you take out this one and write here, and again this 0.6 is there. 0.6, again with 0.6 you need to multiply with 2. You are getting 1.2. so again you are take out this one. Okay. Again this 0.2 is there. Again you multiply with 2, you are getting 0.4. again you take out this 0. Okay. So as I told you, you can truncate to, so you can truncate to 3 or 4 places. You can truncate to 3 or 4 places. So here I truncated to 4 places. So you need to take from top to bottom. Okay. So here what you got? 0.1110. Okay. So what is 23.9, which is in decimal, is equivalent to what is binary? 10111.1110. Okay. So like this, you need to convert whatever the number which is in decimal form to decimal form to binary representation. Okay. So this is about this. Just 1 second. Yeah, any doubts in this? Did you note it down?
Okay.
Okay. So next, so if you want to convert a decimal to other number system, so till now we have seen the decimal to binary number system. We'll see decimal to octal and hexadecimal. Okay. So let us take one number. 2275.4. So this is the decimal number. You need to convert into octal. You need to convert into octal. Okay. So so you know that decimal to other number system. This is nothing but you need to do division. You can remember like this. Okay. You need to do successive division. So 275. So with which one? 8. You need to divide. So 8. How many times? 8 threes are 24. Again, 24, 3 is remaining. So 8 fours are 32. So the remainder is what? 3. Again, 8, how many times 8 fours are 32? And the remainder is 2. Okay, you have to take from bottom to top. Okay, so this is nothing but 423 to the base 8. Okay, this is the octal. Again, separately, you need to take the decimal value 0.4. You need to multiply with 8. Okay, so 0.4 into 8 is how much? 3.2. You have to take out this 3. Again, 0.2 into 8. So this is nothing but 1.6. You have to take out this 1. Again, 0.6 into 8. 8, 6 are how much? 48. Okay, 4.8. So you have to take out this 4. So like this you can do. But here you can truncate to these three numbers. Okay. So what is the value you are getting? 0.314 you are getting. 0.314. You are getting. Okay, so this is in octal. So 275.4 to the base 10 equal to what? 423.314 to the base 8. Okay, so like this you need to convert whatever the decimal value, decimal number is there, into octal. Okay. So we'll see one more example. Did you note it down? Should I scroll down? Okay. So let us take one example. 27.15 to the base 10, you need to convert into octal. Okay, so here 27 is there. You need to do the successive division. So that means 8, how many times? 8 threes are 24. 3 you have to take from bottom to top. Okay, so this is nothing but 33 to the base 8. 33 to the base 8. Again, next 0.15 is there. You need to multiply. So wherever the decimal is there, you need to multiply. So 0.15 into 8 means you are getting 1.2. You have to take out this 1. And 0.2 into 8, so this is 1.6. You have to take out this 1 and you have to multiply the next one with the 0.6. Okay, 0.6 into 8, so this is 4.8. again you take out this 4. Okay, so you truncate to three numbers. Okay, three values. So this is 0.114. okay, so that means 27.15 to the base 10, that is equivalent to what? So this is equivalent to 33.114 to the base 8. So like this, you can convert whatever the decimal number into octal representation. Okay. Now we'll see the hexadecimal representation. Okay. So decimal to hexadecimal representation. Okay. Did you note it down? Anyone? Okay. So next, let us take 64.20. Okay, this is a number. You need to convert into hexadecimal. Okay. So which is having the base 16. So this is decimal to other number system. So that means you need to do the division. So 64 is there. 64 with the radix 16. Hexadecimal radix is 16. You need to do successive division. 16 fours are how much? 64. The remainder is 0. You have to take from bottom to top. So this is nothing but 40 to the base 16. Okay. And 0.20 is there. 0.20 into 16. So how much you are getting? 3.2 is getting. You need to take this 3. Again 0.2 into 16. You are getting 3.2. Again you take this 3. Again 0.2 into 16. You are getting 3.2. Again you take 3. Okay. So you can truncate to three values. So that means what value you are getting? 0.333 to the base 16. Okay. So that means 64.20 to the base 10 equal to what? 40.333 to the base 16. So like this, you can convert whatever the decimal number system is there into hexadecimal number system. Okay. So next problem, you can see. Convert the decimal number40 into binary and hexadecimal. So that means here you have the 40 number. You need to convert into binary, and you need to convert into hexadecimal. Okay, you need to convert into hexadecimal. Okay, so first binary, if you see, okay, so binary, if you see, you need to multiply, you need to do successive division with 40. So to how many tens? 220, the remainder is 0. To 10, the remainder is 0. To 5s, the remainder is 0. To 2s, the remainder is 1. To 1s, the remainder is 0. So you have to take from bottom to top. So that means, so what you are getting? So this is nothing but 10100, okay, to the base 2. So that means 40 in decimal equivalent to what? 10100. Okay. And next, you can see like this also. Suppose you want 40, no? So you want 40, one more method is there. So here the number, the binary numbers are printed is like this: 2 power 1, 2 power 2, 2 power 3, 2 power 4. Okay, like this. So that means 2 power 0 is how much? 1. 2 power 2 is 2, and 2 square is 4. 2 cube is 8, and 2 power 4 is 16. Again, 2 power 5, 32, and 2 power 6 is how much? 64. Okay, so that means you want the 40, no? So 40 number means, anyway, the 40 is less than 64. 64 will not come. So that means the number will be between the these values only. So that means in order to get this 40, you can make this as 32 as 1. Okay, and 32 next plus 8. 32 plus 8 is how much? 40. Okay, remaining you can make 0. Okay, so like this also you can convert the given decimal number into binary. Okay, so that means this is based on the 8421 code. Okay, 8421. So depending on the weights, depending on this value, you need to make the given numbers to ones and zeros. Okay, and next convert into hexadecimal. So this is 16. 16 how many times? 16 twos are 32, and the 8 is the remainder. So you should take bottom to top. So that means 40 in decimal equal to what? 28 in hexadecimal. Okay, so like this you need to convert. Okay. So any doubts in this?
Okay.
The 2 power 64, sir.
2 power? What is your doubt?
2 power 64.
Please pardon, what is your doubt? Yeah, 2 power 64, okay. So 2 power 4 is 16. 2 power 4 is 16. 2 power 5 is 32. 2 power 6 is 64. This is 2 power 5, not 2 power 4. This is 2 power 5. 2 power 5. This is 2 power 5. Okay. 2 power 6 is 64. So the value is 40. So if you see 40 is less than 64 only. So that means 64 will not come. So that means you can see from 2 power 5 to 2 power 0. So that means 32, 16, 8, 4, 2, 1. Okay. So that means you have to see the numbers by adding these numbers, you need to get 40. So how you will get by adding 32 plus 8 is how much? 40. So that means these 32 I can make 1. Remaining all you can make 0s. Okay. Is it okay? Any doubts?
Okay, sir.
Okay. So next, any other number into decimal. Okay. First part is completed. And the second one, any other number system into decimal. Any other number system into decimal. Okay, so that means here any other number means you have binary and you have octal and you have hexadecimal. Okay, so this binary you can convert into decimal, octal you can convert into a decimal, and hexadecimal you can convert into decimal. Okay, so that means the decimal is having the radix 10. Okay, so how you can find out means here what you need to do: summation digit into here 2 power place value. Okay, so that means if we given the binary, you have to do the summation of these digits into 2 power place value, and here also summation of digit into 8 power place value you need to do, 8 power place value, and here summation of digit into 16 power place value you need to do, 16 power place value you need to do. Okay, so suppose so let us take so binary to let us take suppose like a b c dot d is there. Okay, so what is the place value for c? The place value is 0. So from for the integer value, it will be from right to left. Okay, so that means it will follow from right to left, 0 1 2. And if you see for the decimal number, it will be -1 -2. These are the place values, -1 -2 are the place values. Okay, so let us take one example. 1100 is there. Okay, so this is the binary I want to convert into decimal. Okay, I want to convert into decimal. Okay, so for this what you need to do, what is the place value for this one? So this is so this is 0 1 2 3 0 1 2 3. So this is nothing but the digit into 2 power 0. So 2 power place value here, this is the place value. Okay, so again 0 digit into 2 power place value, 2 power 1 plus 1 into 2 power place value, 2 power 2 plus 1 into 2 power 3, 2 power 3. Okay, so okay, so so what you are getting, so this is 8 plus 4 plus 0 plus 0. Okay, so that means what you are getting, 12. You are getting 12. Okay, so another method is, so 1100 is there, so that means this is 2 power 0, 2 power 1, 2 square, 2 cube. Okay, so this is like shortcut if you don't have time in the competitive exams, like so you can write this is 1 2 4 8 8 4 2 1 code. Okay, so that means this is 8 plus 4 plus 0 plus 0, directly you can do, you'll get the 12. Okay, so directly you can get, by seeing this number you can get this one. Okay, let us take one more example. So 1100.01 is there. 1100.01 is there. So here this is 0, 1, 2, 3 are the place values, and here minus 1, minus 2 are the place values. Okay, so what you need to do? So 0 into 2 power 0 plus 0 into 2 power 1 plus 1 into 2 square plus 1 into 2 cube. Okay, so coming to the decimal number, 0 into 2 power minus 1 plus 1 into 2 power minus 2. Okay, so 2 power minus 2. So this is nothing but 8 plus 4 plus 0 plus 0 plus 0 into 2 power minus 1 is how much? 0 only. Okay, again 1 into 2 power minus 2. So 2 power minus 2 is nothing but 1 by 4. This is nothing but 0.25. Okay, 0.25 you are getting. Okay, so this is nothing but 12 plus 0.25. So that is nothing but 12.25. Okay, so that means this binary equivalent equal to 12.25 to the base 10. Okay, so with that weights, digits into with that weights, what are that weights? Weights are nothing but 2 power, so if it is a binary, 2 power place value is that weight. Okay, so digit into that weights, you need to add. Okay, you need to add. We'll see one more example. So find the decimal equivalent of the binary number 1101111. Okay, to the base 2 you need to convert into decimal. Okay, so here what are the place values? 0 1 2 3 4 5 6. Okay, so you need to multiply with the digits into 2 power place values. So 1 into 2 power 0 plus 1 into 2 power 1 plus 1 into 2 square plus 1 into 2 cube plus 0 into 2 power 4 plus 1 into 2 power 5 plus 1 into 2 power 6. Okay, so what is this one? 2 power 6 is how much? 64 plus 2 power 5 is 32 plus what is this one? 0 into something is what? 0 only. And this is 8, and this is 4, this is 2, and this is 1. Okay, so if you add all this, you will get this 111, you will get to the base 10. Okay, so this is the decimal equivalent for the this given binary number. Okay, find the decimal equivalent of the binary number 1101.1101 is there. Okay, so here So you need to find out the place value 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And here minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. Okay. So that means here any other number system to decimal. So that means what you need to do, you need to, you can understand like this, anti-division you need to do. What is the anti-division? Anti-division is nothing but you need to do multiplication. Okay. So so here I am doing 1 into 2 power 0 plus 1 into 2 power 1 plus 0 into 2 square plus 1 into 2 cube plus 1 into 2 power 4 plus 0 into 2 power 5 plus 1 into 2 power 6 plus 1 into 2 power 7. Okay. And here you need to write 1 into 2 power minus 1 plus 1 into 2 power minus 2 plus 0 into 2 power minus 3 plus 1 into 2 power minus 4. 1 into 2 power minus 4. Okay. So what is this one? You can write this is 128 plus 64 plus 0 plus 16 plus 8. Plus 4 plus 2 plus 1 plus 1 by 2 is how much? 0.5. 1 by 2 square. 1 by 4. 1 by 4 is how much? 0.25. Again, 0 into 2 power minus 3 is how much? 0 only. 1 by 2 power 4. 1 by 16. 1 by 16 is how much? 0.0625. 0625. So if you add all this, you will get 219.8125 to the base 10. Okay, so like this you need to convert the given binary number into decimal number system. Okay, binary number system into decimal number system. Do you note it down? Students,
yes, sir.
Yeah. So next, octal to decimal conversion. Octal to decimal conversion. So octal to decimal conversion. So that means octal is having the radix 8. You need to convert into decimal. That is having the radix 10. So what do? You should do. You need to do the summation of digit into 8 power place value. Okay, so here PV is nothing but the place value. You need to remember. So this is nothing but the place value. Suppose 12 in octal is there. You need to convert into decimal. You need to convert into decimal. So how you can do? 2 into, so here the place value is 0, 1. So that means 2 into 8 power 0 plus 1 into 8 power 1. Okay, so this is nothing but 8 plus 2. So what is this? 10. So 10 in decimal. Okay, so this is nothing but 10 in decimal. Okay, so that means if you see this one, so when you are changing the lower base to higher base, when you are changing from the lower base to higher base, what happens to the value? The value will be decreasing. Okay, so when you are changing from lower base to higher base, the value will decrease. So when you are changing from higher base to lower base, okay, so see here, lower base means you are converting octal to hexadecimal. So in the octal you have 12 and the decimal, the in the decimal it becomes 10. So that means value will decrease. Okay, when you are changing from higher base to lower base, the value will increase. Okay, so here you can remember like this. So when you are changing from lower base to higher base, the value will decrease. When you are changing from higher base to lower base, the value will increase. Okay, the value will increase. Okay, so we'll see one more example. 12.10 is there. 12.10 is there. Okay, to the base 8, you need to convert into decimal. Okay, you need to convert into decimal. So here 12.10 is there. So here 0, 1, these are the place values, minus 1, minus 2. Okay, So this is equal to so 2 into 8 power 0 plus 1 into 8 power 1 plus 1 into 8 power minus 1 plus 0 into 8 power minus 2. Okay, so this is nothing but 8 plus 2 plus this is nothing but 1 by 8 plus and 0 into something is 0. Okay, so this is 8 plus 2 plus this is 0.125. So this is nothing but 10.125. So the base 10. Okay, so this is equivalent to what? Equivalent to 10.125. Okay, in decimal. Okay, so like this. So that means you have to, if it is in integer part, you have to multiply with two power place value. So place value should be positive, and in the decimal part you have to multiply with 8 power place value. So for the decimal, 8 power place value should be negative. Okay, for the integer, 8 power place value should be positive. Okay, so that should be positive, that should be increased from left to right. Okay, so one more example. One not 2.11 to the base 8 need to convert into decimal. Okay, so what is the place value? 102.11 is there. 0, 1, 2, -1, -2. Okay, these are the place values. So now you need to multiply digit with the place values, 8 power place values. Okay, 8 power 0 plus 0 into 8 power 1 plus 1 into 8 square plus 1 into 8 power minus 1 plus 1 into 8 power minus 2. Okay, so what is this one? 8 square is how much? 64 plus 0 plus 2 ones are 2 plus, okay, 8 power 0 is 1. Okay, 1 by 8 plus 1 by 64. So this you are getting 64 plus 2, 66, no? 66 plus 0.125 plus 0.0156 you are getting. Okay, so that means this is equal to 66 point you will get 140 to the base 8. Okay, so like this you can do. So like this you can convert whatever the octal number into decimal number representation. Now hexadecimal to decimal number conversion. Okay, yeah, so we'll see this one in the next class. Anyway, the time is 10:20 over. Okay.